from New York, the Dick Cavett Show. It's not easy living on your own. With Mick Jagger in an exclusive film interview, the Rolling Stones in concert at Madison Square Garden, and Bobby Fischer in an interview recorded prior to the start of the World Chess Championship in Reykjavik, Iceland. Ladies and gentlemen, Dick Cavett.
That's because the whole show is a little different tonight. Thank you. I'm going to explain how. Last week, New York City finally got to see and hear the Rolling Stones. We were the last stop on a tour that I'm sure most of you have heard about, because it was reported all over the country. Took them into 30 cities in about 6 weeks, a grueling trip. It earned them, according to published estimates, between $3 and $4 million. And the tour was amazingly complicated, not only logistically in terms of moving them and the more than 100 people that travel with them and all the equipment from city to city, but their last tour of the United States had ended in a place called Altamont, California, where four people in the audience of a free and unscheduled concert died, one of them from stab wounds, and the argument goes on about how and what is to blame for that, or how that could have been prevented, I should say. Anyway, with that in mind, they came to the States again. Mick Jagger, the singer with the group, a fascinating man. He's been described variously as the supreme sexual object in modern Western culture. That's a quote. A compound of menace and energy is another one. A sadomasochistic freak is another one, and a musical genius, and a pussycat, various other things. Last Tuesday afternoon, anyway, I went to Madison Square Garden to meet Mick Jagger and the Rolling Stones and to talk to them and the people around them and find out who and what they are. And I don't know if I found out exactly, but tonight on the show, you will be seeing the results of that visit. I had hoped to be able to talk to Mick Jagger more than I did. He had two concerts that day, and he was going to be there between them. But as you'll see, he was so beat from the first concert. He left the building right after the first concert. I did have time to ask him some things. And we have for you tonight, then, an impression, I think a fairly accurate one, of what goes on outside, inside, and backstage at Madison Square Garden when the Rolling Stones are in town. It will occupy the first hour of the show tonight, and it's fascinating. After that, you'll be seeing an interview which I did with Bobby Fischer, a chess genius. That was back in January. And at that time, he knew that he would be beating Boris Spassky, beating him as a Freudian slip, for the World Championship sometime this summer. And he has a lot of interesting things to say about how to outwit an opponent. When the interview first ran, a lot of you probably didn't know who Bobby Fischer was. Now it seems everybody knows, and I don't think that he's changed that much in the last 6 months. My only regret is that Bobby Fischer and Mick Jagger are here together. Interesting to find out what they have to say to each other. Fischer could tell Mick how it's best to work in silence, and Jagger could explain groupies to Fischer. It'd be fun to see his face when he does. Anyway, we'll be back after this message with the first piece of film from Madison Square Garden. Stay with us.
Which glass would you rather drink from? Two new glasses. We washed each one 10 times. The glass on left in a leading automatic dishwasher detergent. Glass on right in new formula Calgonite. Glass on left has visible residue. Calgonite glass is clearer. Because of Calgonite's exclusive new formula, your glasses can be cleaner than they are now. Look again. The choice is yours. Which glass would you rather drink from? There's something very special about being a woman. You do so much for everyone near you, yet your own system is delicate. When you're not feeling your best because of irregularity, take Correctol, the woman's gentle laxative. Correctol's special formula combines a mild laxative with a softening moisturizer. Its gentle overnight action will help you feel like yourself again. Next time, try Correctol, the woman's gentle laxative.
Howdy, I'm Steve Allen, and I'm deeply concerned about the natural beauty of our country. I want you to know that Dotson shares that concern, and they're doing something about it. Between now and October 15th, when you take a test drive, Dotson will pay the U.S. Forest Service to plant a tree in a national forest. Our goal is over 100,000 trees. Now, this is no ordinary program, but Datsun's no ordinary car. For example, the Datsun 510 sedan and 1200 Sport Coupe both include features that make them outstanding values. Things like safety front disc brakes, reclining bucket seats, tinted glass, white walls, and lots more. So why not try one? Your Datsun dealer is doing something worthwhile to get you to test drive a Datsun. Take him up on it. Drive a Datsun. Plant a tree.
Take a test drive and find out about Datsun's value. Get a free Ansel Adams nature poster, too. Offer good at all participating dealers.
There had been people milling around outside Madison Square Garden for weeks before the Rolling Stones actually arrived. The ticket was literally the hottest ticket in town. There were reports that distraught fans had forked out over $100 a seat to scalpers, and they all cost $6.50, but you could only get them by sending in a postcard. I tried to swap a couple tickets to No No Nanette, but I didn't get anywhere. And then I went into the garden to meet Jagger and the band. Before I did, though, I talked to some of the people waiting to get in, and here's that. What are you doing here?
Well, I've been a fan for a long time. I came to the 69 concert, and I had to come to this one.
You came to the 69 concert?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How do you get tickets for this?
I sent in 66 postcards.
Is that fair?
Sure. I'd do anything to get here.
Would you say you're fanatical about the Stones, or do you just like them a lot?
Well, I'm not really a fanatic about it, but this is what's going on in the city now. I mean, it's a summer vacation, you gotta live. And,
yeah.
I'm not as freaky as some of the kids are, but I like to see the concert.
Yeah. Is it what's going to happen on stage that you want to see mostly, or is it what's inside in the audience too, you know what I mean?
Well, it's going to be a total experience, and I really don't want to miss it.
Yeah. What do you think about Jagger?
What do I think about Jagger? Well,
yeah.
He is, he's one of a kind, put
yeah.
it that way, yeah. There's no one like him.
If you met him, what would you want to know about from him? If you could ask him anything.
I'd ask him what he was on.
I sent a card in, and they picked my name out, I guess.
Did you only send one card in?
No, I sent six. And I got it on my girlfriend's name, Jan.
Were you thrilled when it came in the mail?
I got it Wednesday. I almost had a heart attack. She called me up. We gave up hope, and she called me up and said, they called me today, and they said, you got a ticket. And I was like, oh, my God, I don't believe it.
If I were Mick Jagger, what would you want to know from me?
How much do you weigh?
What do I weigh?
Yeah.
Why do you want to know that?
I don't know. I always like to know how much people weigh.
You figure he weighs more after a concert than before?
No, less, because he works so much.
That's what I meant. I got it backwards.
Oh.
My eyes deceive me. Are you a postman?
What is it?
Are you a postman?
Yes, sir. And I like to see a lot of young people. It means that I like rock music at the same time, even though I'm past 30, but still I feel under 30. So you can all trust me.
Well, Jagger will be past 30 in a year or so, won't he?
It's all right, but I'm still going to like him even then, and I think he could go till 40.
Do you have a ticket?
No, I'm still working. I can go see the show, and I don't want to pay $75 for a scalper, no matter how much I like the rocks.
You have a slight accent? Where are you from?
I'm Israeli.
The thing I like to know from Mick is, like, now that he's much older, if he enjoys playing to the crowds that are so much younger than he was, like, years ago when he was playing to his own, like, peer group, like.
Do you think it's the same crowd that used to come, or is it a younger crowd while he's getting older?
It's definitely a younger crowd than it used to be.
It's younger, but it's the same crowd.
How old are you two?
Well, I'm 21.
You're 20.
Basically, most of the people I think are younger. They've been saying across the country. And I'm wondering how he feels about it.
Yeah.
So I just wonder how he feels.
My mother wants
if he's still enjoying performing to a much younger crowd than to his own peers or whatever. If he thinks he's playing to people much below him, or you know, not that the people are below him, but just like his music quality.
I just wanted to make a comment about the difference between the crowd, let's say today, as opposed to 2 years ago. And that's it. You know, like a lot of people come to the concert now, and they know they're not going to come in, get in, and they come to make trouble, and it sort of ruins, like, the nice thing, you know, that about concerts that, you know, used to be kind of atmosphere. And now, like, people are scalping tickets for three times the value of their worth, and I don't think it's a very nice thing. And I wish, you know, I just like to ask people to stop doing it, and I'd also like, you know, Mick Jagger, to say the way that he feels about it, because I'm sure he doesn't condone behavior like that.
Maybe I get a chance to ask him later.
Yeah.
Are you coming to the concert?
No.
Why are you here then?
I don't know.
Why aren't you in school?
There's no school.
That's right. I want to see if you knew. Yeah. Oh, hi. Come in. Step in.
My children will die.
Wait. You have your children with you?
No, they're at home.
Where are you from?
Porchester, New York.
Are you a housewife?
Yes, mother.
And you're going to the concert?
Mm-hmm.
How did you get tickets and how many?
I just bought one up the street.
Hold on to it very tight. Hold on to it because people have been known to get them away from people. Did you know about that?
$25. Wow, that's
pretty cheap. $25. But are you going or are your children?
No, I am. They're going tomorrow night. Oh.
Do they know you're here?
Yes. I hope.
Is your husband a Stones fan?
No.
Just you?
And my children really turned me on to the music, and that's how I grew to love it, and that's how come I'm here. Oh, I feel foolish.
Well, you shouldn't feel foolish. You do have a poster of Mick Jagger up in the kitchen or anything?
No.
Nothing like that. You just like the sound?
Yes, I just like them.
Do you know where you'll be sitting?
I hope in a good seat. They said it was...
Get my hands on
it. Put it back. Yeah. I'm nervous.
Oh.
Man's upset about being behind the stage here. No, I think
there's some little letters. It's hidden on the side of the table.
Yeah, behind stage. I got those little letters.
When you get home, you see it. Then you flip out.
Yeah,
at least you're there.
There.
At least you're there. Hear the music.
Would you want to meet Mick Jagger? I can't arrange it. But I mean, if you did, do you have any idea what you'd talk about?
I have a son that reminds me of him.
How old is the son?
He's 8 years old.
Uh-huh. Darn young.
But Jagger is twice that old.
Just something about him reminds me of him. I have a few children, and he's just different from all the rest.
School twice that old.
Never mind.
And being so different, I don't know. He just does.
I'll be talking to Mick Jagger after this message. Stay with us.
Being chief of police in our town doesn't qualify me as an expert on pain relievers, but I learned some very important things about pain relievers from this booklet. For example, I thought all aspirin was the same. So did my wife. She used to come home with brands of aspirin I personally never heard of. Not anymore. I read about recent Bayer tests on aspirin. They tested for quality, for purity, for freshness against 220 other brands. The test showed that Bayer makes the superior aspirin. Did you know that the techniques for making Bayer are different from all the others? That's the reason Bayer is a better quality aspirin. I also read about another recent report in here. The Council on Drugs of the American Medical Association prefers straight aspirin. Among non-prescription pain relievers, straight aspirin was preferred over buffered pain relievers, over combination pain relievers. Find out why aspirin's the best pain reliever, and Bayer is the best aspirin.
Wow is excitement, wow is laughter, wow is fun, wow is now!
Cranberry's Wow, original entertainment for summer.
We're here on ABC for just one reason.
Saturday night.
I don't like labels, because they may lump you with people with whom you share only one issue.
A rare spirit of independence and freshness of outlook are reflected in all of Harry Reasoner's commentaries. It's one reason people look forward to hearing what he has to say.
I promise to try to stay surprised enough at life to learn something new if I trip over it. I invite you to join me in that promise.
Harry Reasoner, on the ABC Evening News.
In order for me and my jolly film crew to actually get inside Madison Square Garden, we had to wear strange buttons with battleships and strange pieces of silver tape on, and the security was amazing. There was also a general sense of tight security. I was told that those with tickets had to show them to at least six different sets of guards, from New York policemen to ticket takers inside the garden. A lot of people were searched. However, we did get inside, and then we began to wait. I began to wonder if the man I had talked to on the phone was Mick Jagger and if he was going to show up. I'm still wondering. Let's take a look. One of these two men is my producer. The other is Gary Stromberg, who's public relations man for the Stones. A lot of people milling around backstage. Bill Wyman there, a Stone I talked to later. Let's see. That's Chipmunk, who's a lighting genius, who I offered a carrot and he refused. There were chopped carrots backstage. Guy who's about to... there's an unidentified groupie. No, it's Princess Red's. No, it couldn't be. I think Keith Richard is going to drop something. Somebody's going to drop something. You can't hold out. You can't hold out. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. You can't hold out. I think, you can't hold out. Oh, yeah, Mick Taylor, oh, yeah. The president of the London Stock Exchange. For someone to come out of somewhere. Lady with a child. That, I think I see Jagger taking a camera shot of the people who are taking pictures of him. He's getting back at them. He's one of the most photographed people around. Spence was killing us. I still didn't know if he was going to come over or if he'd remember me. He seems to be going away, folks.
I can see him coming, folks.
Oh, I see him coming, folks.
Get him over here. His arm with a camera. Mick.
Hi, Mick.
Hey, that isn't fair. You're not supposed to do me. I'm supposed to be doing you. Would you like a carrot? Should we go in here where it's...
Yeah. Where there are less people? Okay.
Oh, well, you go. Morning.
Can you sort of tell me where, my way around in here? I don't know who's who and what's what. Who's... What? Doesn't all this upset you, all these people?
Yeah, it's a great crowd for a morning show.
Yeah.
I bet the band's hidden.
How did you sleep after the opening night last night?
Not very well, man.
Didn't sleep?
Didn't sleep at all.
Yeah.
I just slept a couple of hours.
Do you pop up in the morning after opening night and grab the papers and do any of that stuff? That thing. Okay. I just thought I'd check that. Say, I don't know if I was supposed to see this or not, but there was a plate of something going around, people offering me little pills.
Vitamins and salt.
Vitamins and salt pills.
Yeah.
That's what they told me they were, but you didn't really...
C and salt.
Yeah.
Clean the salt with plenty of water.
Yeah. Will that help? Do you do any kind of exercises every day to keep... So you don't...
Yeah, last night I forgot.
So you
did a warm-up exercise and I pulled a muscle. That's the way it goes.
You ever hurt yourself on stage?
No.
I was talking to the kids outside before I came in here, and they were very upset about the scalping. They said some guys are offering tickets for $75, and they said that ruins the atmosphere for them, and they wouldn't know if you agreed and all that.
But that's just a free enterprise system, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, the tickets aren't set $75, you know?
I know.
I mean,
I guess
and also, they're arresting scalpers, you know? They arrested lots and lots of them yesterday, which, I mean, you may or may not agree with.
I wonder what the penalty is for that.
Well, a very small fine, you know?
When you were in the London School of Economics, were you a Keynesian economist or what?
That's what I was. I was bribed. That's what I was told that I was going to be. Yeah, Keynesian. Yeah.
And how did you decide not to graduate? Or did you graduate?
Just decided.
Yeah, 2 years. Do you ever run into your old friends from the economics school? And
no, I had a few guitar players that were there, but I hadn't seen them for a long time.
Yeah.
But I didn't think that really that. I couldn't understand. They told me that I couldn't, until I took the master's degree, I never really get into it, you know, because there's so many unknown factors in Keynesian economics. So I didn't bother.
You didn't want to give your life to that?
No.
Did they get all upset in England as much as they did here for a time about lyrics of what can be sung on the air?
Oh yeah, they're still really into it.
Yeah.
No, they won't, and they won't. If you say any advertised brand name, they won't play the record either.
Well, there was a big
Cadillac
here. All
won't play that.
If you say a brand.
If you say, I drove up in a Cadillac, they won't play it.
Yeah.
Because of all kinds of problems.
What about when there was a whole thing here about any lyrics that mentioned drugs, whether they could be played or not? There was a big flap over that. Do they have that over there, too?
Yeah, a bit of that. Yeah. They banned a lot of records.
What's the theory behind that? They figure that if people hear any mention of drugs on the air, they're immediately going to run out and start taking them.
Yeah. They've got all kinds of other things, you know. But where they think that any kind of they want to be clever, so any kind of reference to anything, if they can twist it around to mean something else, they'll stop playing the record.
Yeah.
They don't want to play records in England on the radio, basically.
Have you ever been approached to give advice? I know a lot of rock superstars have been asked to make commercials about drugs and things and advice.
No one's ever asked me to do it.
Yeah. I
don't know what I'd do if they did. I once made some ads for people in Virginia to get polio shots, that's all. Or something like that. Or workers in mines to get this injection against that. I'm sure they didn't know who I was, but I did.
Yeah. Are you your mother and dad both alive?
Yeah.
Do they ever see you work?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
In London.
They think of their wandering boy.
I don't know. Yeah.
Can they come to concerts?
Do you want to do it all now, Dick? Excuse me.
We could. Yeah, we can cut.
Because I've got to get ready. No, I don't have a lot of time because he's nearly finished.
Okay.
Stevie. Gives me 20 minutes.
Well, I'll talk to him some more later. And we'll be back in the interview with Bill Wyman right after this message.
This September, two new comedies come to ABC.
Hello, dear. How goes the rat race?
The rats are winning.
What is it? It's the Aztec goddess of fertility.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Don't touch it.
From the joys of family living with Paul Lynde to the tidy, regulated hospital routine of temperatures rising.
Whoops. Okay, all right.
Excuse me, ma'am. Sir.
On earth,
I think I love you.
Excuse me, sir. Tonight.
Who is that?
Brand new.
I'm sure I love you.
Oh, I'm already spoken for.
James Whitmore, Cleavon Little. Temperatures rising.
Jim Ryan, a world record holder for the mile, is up at dawn every day for a grueling 10-mile run. Training, just as hundreds of other milers around the world are training for a chance to win at this year's Summer Olympics. When these athletes meet in Munich, in that singular spirit of comradeship and competition that marks the Olympics, ABC Sports will be there to bring you their story. Up close and personal, the ABC way.
Jagger went off to put on his spangles and fringes, and the rest of the group seemed to be just sort of sitting around in a relaxed fashion waiting for Stevie Wonder to finish, who was the first part of the concert. Bill Wyman's a bass player for the Rolling Stones. He seemed like a friendly chap, so I asked him a couple of questions. I must say I felt a little bit like the illegitimate son of the Eyewitness News team here, but it was fun. Here's me and Bill Wyman. By the way, it's a banana on his T-shirt.
What's running through your nervous system right now, Bill? Are you worried? Are you scared? Did matinees give you willies or anything?
No. I'm just tired.
How about your feet?
Pretty tired.
Would you ever do 30 cities again in that amount of time if it were up to you?
Yeah.
I think it's been too close together.
As long as I get a holiday, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. But we've done it before a lot of times.
You're so protected from this.
There's never been so much energy as on this tour, you know.
Yeah.
We've had about five tours before, 30, 35 cities, 40 cities.
I wonder what happened on this one that made it that way. Why is it?
It's just the energy. It's just a tremendous thing all the time on stage, you know. It always used to be screamers, you know.
Yeah.
And they didn't seem to worry much about the music, but it was being played at the same time, but you never heard it. But now you hear everything, and you see everything, and there's so much tension. And sort of,
can you tell if it's the same audiences that came to earlier tours, or are you hitting a younger group now that hadn't seen Stones tours before?
Before, we used to hit the sort of 15 to 20s. Now it's the 15 to 30s. The fans grew up, and they're still coming, and the younger ones are starting coming as well, which is great. You know, you're not playing those old people. You're not getting the mums and dads coming after all, you know. We didn't really want them.
The old, very old people who like Tom Jones.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Is Tom Jones that old?
Well, I don't know how old Tom is, but I always heard that middle-aged ladies were very excited by Tom.
I think Tom's excited by middle-aged ladies as well.
That's an exclusive then. I didn't know about that. Are you a chain smoker?
No.
You smoke very much?
No.
You're down to the, you're burning the filter there.
No, I'm not.
Oh, you're not?
No.
Well, one of us is right. Where do you come from?
What looks town? Like I'm burning the filter. London.
Yeah.
South London.
How much schooling did you get?
I went to grammar school, which is, it's a school below university. I don't know what you call it. I went to about 16 and a half.
Did you like school?
Yeah, school was all right. I like sport.
Yeah. Have you ever thought of going back when you're finished with all this?
To school.
Did they do that much in England?
No.
Yeah. Once you quit, you quit.
Yeah, yeah. Most kids leave about 15 and a half in England. Mm-hmm. So you start at 4 years old in England. Three and a half.
Right.
Like in Sweden, they don't start school.
Do you mature faster than we do somewhere? Maybe it's the weather. Can you imagine, can you picture yourself at 50? Have you ever thought of what you'd be doing in 50 or 60? I had Lennon.
I have no idea what I'm doing next year. I don't know, about 50.
Yeah.
I don't know. Retired. Doing,
if the Stones broke up, I don't want to start any rumors because there aren't any, but if they did, say next week after this tour, what would you do? Retire? Form another group?
No, I'd just get together with some people and play some more music, make some more records. I mean, not. I wouldn't form a group, but I'd probably join some other people, some nice musicians.
Yeah.
But we're not, so it doesn't matter.
You couldn't just turn off the music for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
Who are those kids over there?
The little girl is the blonde there. That's Shirley's. Charlie and Shirley's. Charlie Watts, the drummer's little
drummer.
Girl.
Yeah.
I don't know the other one. The Mark is the other one, the tall one, the boy. That's Jim Price, the trumpet player's little boy.
Yeah.
He's got another one at the hotel. Mine's at the hotel today as well. They're just taking it easy.
What will you do when you get back now from this tour? Do you have a period of rest?
Yeah, I'm going to Bermuda for a week. I've got relatives there, so it's nice and quiet. I can relax.
Does your family ever come to the concerts and see you perform? You know, I mean, your older relatives?
No.
They don't?
No, they do in England sometimes, but they're very rarely, you know.
Has there been anything on this trip that scared you? Or bad moments? Or you were really worried that something was going to happen? Menacing?
No, just seeing the cops beat kids up scares me sometimes.
You know what?
When you see the cops beat the kids up, that scares me a bit sometimes.
Was there much of that this time?
Not too much, not as much as usual, but we have seen it. You know, you do see them grab guys out of the audience, take them out.
Yeah.
They go through a whole thing on the way, you know, with sticks, and it's pretty rough, you know, they don't deserve it.
Is there such a thing as too much security for the concert? Can it affect how you play?
Yeah, it's all right, as long as they don't get in the way, you know. They usually sort of try to get in the front there and stop, and they cause more trouble than there is, you know. As soon as you clear the cops away, then it's all cool. It happened at a lot of shows where cops were in the front and there was a lot of trouble going on, and we got the cops to go, you know, and then it was fine. The kids were fine, you know. It's just that thing, the cops are in the way and they want to get past them, you know.
Do the guys in the group still talk about Altamont ever and what happened there? Is that faded?
We talk about it, yes, but I don't. I'd sooner
have any
like
theories
to forget about it, you know.
Yeah.
It's just a very unfortunate thing. It was the last show of a tour, and we weren't going to do it. It was just a live concert.
Yeah.
A free concert that was set up a few days before, and I mean, there was, 300,000 people there. There was only 30 people fighting. I mean, almost all the audience never even saw it. Didn't even know what was going on, you know?
Can you walk out on stage ever and know it's just a bad night if the audience is not with you and something's wrong and bad atmosphere, bad vibes?
You know, it hasn't happened on this tour, you know. You get more hung up about whether the sound on the stage is good, whether you can hear everybody, you know, we've got monitors everywhere.
Professional problems.
Yeah. And whether your amplifier blows up, you know, that's...
Better if it
doesn't blow. But the audiences have been fantastic, you know, very receptive.
We'll be back with more talk with Mick Jagger, and you'll see some of the concert after this station break.
The Dick Cavett Show with Mick Jagger and the Rolling Stones and Bobby Fischer will continue following station identification. Arms and security, how much is enough? A Monday night special on ABC. Waiting for someone to come out of Dick Cavett Show will continue following this message. It seems a big failing in a
man. Sometimes a man doesn't have time to take care of his face, to protect it against the things a face runs up against during the day. That's why there's High C's, the new conditioning aftershave. It conditions and protects your face, helps keep it from drying out. High C's, it's a new kind of aftershave. High C's. It takes care of your face while you take care of other things.
As soft and fresh as rainwater, introducing Rain Barrel from Johnson. The fabric softener that works in the wash cycle. Rain Barrel goes in first because it works with detergents. Makes everything feel rainwater soft, rainwater fresh. Rain Barrel works in the wash. Buy the new 70-ounce Rain Barrel and get coupons worth $2.25 on 8 Johnson products. Look for me at your store.
By now, Stevie Wonder had finished his set, and there's a tremendous tension in the place. And the Jagger and the Stones were all set to go on. And I waited for him in a room while somebody took some pictures of him with a prize fighter out in the hall. There are weird things always going on backstage at Madison Square Garden. Probably right now as we sit here they are, but he eventually came inside and allowed me to inflict myself on him again right before going on, which I think is very nice. As you look at this, it's literally only minutes until he goes outside onto a stage and exudes solid energy to 20,000 people. Notice how calm we both are, even though he had 20,000 people waiting and I had three listless staff members waiting for a cab for me. If anybody... Are you all right?
No, I'm just beating the insects off.
And they're everywhere. Well, I thought you got all that. Okay. If anybody tried to see me just before a performance like this, I'd be furious. I didn't know you were so good about things like this.
I am like furious.
This. Are you?
No, I'm not really. I don't know. That's all right.
Yeah. The rumor that you're going to call me on stage during the show to sing something from Gilbert and Sullivan, I think, is very exciting. Is there any truth to this?
Yes, there is. You have to come on at the end and do the duet, because we're not doing the duet with Stevie Wonder in the afternoon show, so you can do it.
So you and I are doing Ted Willow?
Yes.
Later on? Okay. That'll be good. A girl outside was very worried about your weight and had to know exactly what it is. Do you mind revealing anything that intimate?
Yes. 10 kilos.
Well, I'm sure she'll be glad to know that, and we'll go right to the library to figure it out. Mick, how do you move around in public?
A twist and a spin.
No, I know that. I mean, could you go from, if you wanted to walk from the hotel over here, have you ever thought of getting a crew cut?
I wouldn't get in, man. The policemen are too heavy out there.
Yeah. Can this bother you too much, security? Can it affect the audience?
It does. But you know, you have to try and find a happy medium, and one's not totally in control, because, like, in a lot of these towns, you know, like the police, like they have their own thing of what they're going to do, you know, so, you know, they're going to do it anyway, you know, whatever you say, you know, we've got to have X amount of people, or, you know.
They're sort of out of your control.
Well, not always, but I mean, you try and talk to them, some of them are really nice and reasonable, and some of them aren't, you know.
Do you ever stand on stage and get a sense of menace or worry, or does it feel about the same each show?
Oh, it's too different, yeah.
It is different.
Yeah, I mean...
Can you walk out and tell what it's going to be like that night? Can you say this is a bad night?
As soon as you get on there, yeah, you know.
Yeah.
You know what the audience is like. Yeah.
Do you read poetry?
No.
And this is you?
Well, sometimes. You were registered at a hotel, I won't say what, but under the name of a 18th century poet at one point, and I just wondered if that was...
I haven't read him for years.
Damn it.
No. His is only a slim volume. No, it's quite light, actually, but I read it once.
Yeah. Do you write yourself?
I didn't realize you had notes.
Notes?
I thought you had notes. I thought it was all just straight off.
What notes?
Okay.
I do it. It's all. Well, what's going through you now? Are you nervous? Are you about ready to bounce on stage?
Yeah, I'm
do you
yeah.
feel any anxiety or anything like that?
Yeah.
Why aren't I afraid of you? Now, I had read all these things about you, and some people called you the devil incarnate. I don't know who started that. British journalists and all.
I don't know.
And yet, the other day when we were throwing stones into the sea, you were very calm, and you're not terrifying in person.
No, it would have been even... If you'd have come on the horse, maybe I would have turned into a terrifying aspect.
How do you know I have a horse?
Oh, I know.
It's amazing. What else do you want to know about me? I have a little time here, if you want to talk.
I don't have much, Dick.
I know. I really do appreciate your doing this.
Well, I have about 2 minutes.
Would you ever do 30 cities in a row this fast again?
Yeah. Do it now. Give me a week off, though. I just want a week off.
You can go right back into it again?
Yeah. But a week off, maybe 2 weeks.
Gee.
Some bands do that. I mean, you know, we're not very hardworking, really. Some bands down the road all the time.
Is there ever a temptation right now, when a whole audience is out there waiting for you, to just say, to chuck it and just say, I don't want to do it, I can't go on, it's just, they're asking too much of me? Because you earn every cent with that performance you give. It's unbelievable. The exercise, the energy, the fact that you lose probably 10 pounds a night.
I can't remember what the question was.
I don't remember either now. I completely lost sight of it.
I was saying, there is a temptation sometimes.
Yeah.
When you're not there, you know, when you have a real problem to get there or something, you know. Like the other night when we were in jail. Like
when you were in jail?
Yeah, I mean, Keith and I were in the thing, yeah. And he was one side and I was the other, and we had this wall, and I say, well, it didn't look like we're going to make it, so let's just forget about it and not try and make it. So Keith says, we've got to make it. So I say, okay, we've got to make it. So we start yelling out. We've got to make it, you know. We didn't have to. We didn't do it, though. I mean, you know, they did it. Got us out on that.
Can you picture yourself at the age 60 doing what you do now?
Yeah, easily, yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Going on stage with a cane and moving the way you do?
No, there's a lot of people that do it at 69. I think it's a bit weird, you know, but they seem to still get their rocks off at it. Marlene Dietrich, she still does it. And she's more than 60.
She still does it?
Yeah. She did it in London, yeah.
Really? I didn't realize
she's
that.
More than 60.
I had rumors that she does, but I didn't
I think
know
I've got the right person. I'm a bit confused at that area.
Falling in love again, never wanted to.
I don't know.
What am I to do? I can't help it. What am I doing, singing?
You're doing very well.
Do you suppose if we... I don't know if there's... Your world seems so different, and yet we seem to be able to talk easily. I don't know what
You've
it is.
You've got this mania for talking, though. And that's why.
I don't really. I'm not a natural talker. I could go for months without talking. Are you shy? Could you go for weeks without saying a word to anybody?
Yeah.
And enjoy
it? I do.
It?
Yeah.
Somebody said I never found a companion who was as companionable as solitude. I don't know who said it, but isn't it?
That's quite nice.
Can I identify with that?
Can I give you the next line? Oh, no.
Yeah.
Cut. You ran out
okay.
of film.
I've got to go.
Obviously, we will be back after this message. You will see Jagger go on stage and we'll see the Stones performing. Stay with us.
Hi. Hey, is company coming?
No. Whatever gave you that idea?
Hey, Mom, is it okay if I...
What?
Oh, do I have to get dressed for dinner?
No, you just sit right down.
Is your mother coming?
No.
Who's the company?
No company. Just us.
Your family is among the nicest people in the world, aren't they? So why shouldn't you treat them like company every night? Jell-O has a new dessert that fits right in with that kind of thinking. It's called Soft Swirl, a totally new kind of dessert that's rich and creamy, yet light enough to peek and swirl. And you can serve Soft Swirl 15 minutes after you first think of it. Make any day a little special with new Jell-O Soft Swirl in peach, vanilla, strawberry, and chocolate.
Hey, Mom. Thanks for having us.
You couldn't have known it. It wasn't in the script.
And then suddenly, you're close up. That's why you always need clear close-up toothpaste. With two whiteners to make your teeth their whitest. And a real mouthwash to make your breath close-up fresh. Close-up toothpaste. For the whitest teeth. The freshest breath. Because you never know when you're going to be close-up.
That's mine.
Red Devil has kept America beautiful for 100 years. To celebrate, here's a 100th anniversary offer. $2.98 value miniature plants. Just $1 plus postage with coupon from your retailer. Get one plant for every Red Devil product you buy, like a putty knife. Or buy other Red Devil products like instant tile grout or new latex caulk. Red Devil products make all home care jobs easier. Buy them at your favorite hardware or paint supply outlet. It's easy with the Devil.
Right, if you've been keeping up with me so far, you know that I've talked to Jagger. He's about to go out there to face 20,000 screaming people. He's also going to sing to them. I went to the concert the night before, and I was surprised to read in the New York Times that the decibel level inside the house was, in the garden that night, was beyond the commonly quoted level of pain. This time, I went back with earplugs, which helped, because it cut out the audience noise. I could still hear, and it didn't hurt afterwards. But anyway, you're probably going to see now more of Jagger performing than some of the people there did, a lot of them. So let's follow him now out onto the stage and let him do what he does in his way. Right here.
I was all right. When you cut it all up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll see you later. Before you go. Before you... Yeah. Well, yeah.
Thank you.
I thought as a service for those under or over 30 who couldn't understand the words to that song, which, by the way, is called Brown Sugar, I thought I'd read the first verse to. It is Gold Coast slave ship bound for cotton fields, sold in a market down in New Orleans. Scarred old silver, know he's doing all right. Hear him whip the women just around midnight. Ah, brown sugar, how come you taste so good? Ah, brown sugar, just like a young girl should. Many of you remember that as a single 20 years ago by Les Paul and Mary Ford. We'll be right back.
You know why I use Flex Balsam and Protein Hair Conditioner by Revlon? Because Flex lasts right through to your next shampoo. Flex gives your hair terrific body and makes it so manageable right through to your next shampoo. Flex works inside the hair shaft, so what you get, you keep. Flex is the conditioner that lasts right through to your next shampoo. Does yours?
Flex Balsam and Protein by Revlon. Beautiful.
Try looking at a Volkswagen this way. It's the only small car which leaves nothing exposed beneath it. And the VW is built to take a little punishment. In fact, it's practically airtight. Now, what other car gives you this kind of quality at this kind of price?
Headache is killing me. When she gets a pain in the head, it can be a big pain to me. So I give her Vanquish.
Vanquish is strong medicine. Vanquish contains more pain relievers than the largest selling extra strength tablet. And it has gentle buffers.
How's your headache, honey?
Vanquish is strong medicine.
Look, we want you to plug Levi's slacks and jeans on TV in a way that shows how many different kinds there are, okay? Dynamite. Levi's knit slacks for men. Beautiful. Oh, how about Levi's for boys? Flawless. Electric slacks. Perfect man for the job of plugging Levi's. He's brilliant.
I wish we had more of the performance for you, and we do. There's something actually quite spectacular about the way Jagger and the group perform, so that what you're seeing seems to me, in many cases, exciting in a different way on film than it is when you're there. But it was exciting there last Tuesday afternoon. For those of you who may be initiates to the Stones, you will see something which could be alarming in this next number. This is the last number of their show, and there's quite a frenzy by this time. And actually, everyone in the audience is hot and exhausted, and Mick at one point throws rose petals onto various members of the group and also ice water from big bowls onto members of the group and people in the audience. I thought I'd warn some of you about that in case you think a riot is breaking out on your television screen. It wasn't that. The atmosphere was frenzied but peaceful in a strange way. And here are Jagger and the Stones now doing their last number. This was last Tuesday's concert in New York, and you'll see him cut away afterwards.
All right.
Mick and the Stones get out of there while the applause is still going on, for probably obvious reasons, if you can see what the condition the audience is in at that time. And I thought it would be funny to say to him, would you take that last number once more with a little feeling? But I didn't get a chance to do that. I'm sure he would have been amused. We'll be back after this message with Bobby Fischer. Stay where you are. I am waiting.
Ellie Daniel is 22, older than most American women swimmers. But her extraordinary strength and her experience, backed by 3 Olympic medals, should serve her well at this year's Summer Olympics. Right now, it's training and hard work for Ellie and hundreds of athletes around the world. When these athletes meet in Munich this summer, ABC Sports will be there to bring you their story, up close and personal, the ABC way.
Howard K. Smith, newsman, co-anchor man on the ABC Evening News. In the far places of the world, or here in his own library, Howard K. Smith analyzes and interprets the day's events with an insight developed during 30 years of award-winning broadcast journalism. Howard K. knows a lot about what's going on in the world, and he shares what he knows with you weeknights on the ABC Evening News.
This is the place to be this September for The Men. Each week, one of 3 suspense adventure series. Glenn Garth Gregory, research assistant with a government agency. One of those dull routine jobs.
The Delphi Bureau, it's a research outfit. That's what I do.
Larry Luckinbill, one of the men. Frank Dane is a cop. He runs a missing persons bureau.
Some of your old friends let me find you for them.
They'll kill us.
I'd like to help them.
James Wainwright, one of the men. If it happens in Vienna's underworld, Jake Webster knows about it.
Getting nervous, Caldwell?
Should I be?
Well, I would.
Robert Conrad, one of the men.
The show will continue following station identification. The FBI tangles with a deadly mother Sunday on ABC.